Hello, everybody. Welcome to Hatha Yoga. Please grab your strap or something that you can use that's like a strap. A couple of yoga blocks, maybe a blanket if you want to start on that. Let's start in a comfortable seat of your choice. I'd like to read an excerpt from Thich Nhat Hanh's classic book, Peace is Every Step. The path of mindfulness in everyday life. And he says in his chapter on interbeing, if you were a poet, you will see clearly that there is a cloud floating in this sheet of paper. Without a cloud, there will be no rain. Without rain, the trees cannot grow. And without trees, we cannot make paper. The cloud is essential for the paper to exist. If the cloud is not here, the sheet of paper cannot be here either. So we can say that the cloud and the paper inter are. Interbeing is a word that is not in the dictionary yet. But if we combine the prefix inter with a verb to be, we have a new verb, interbe. If we look into the sheet of paper even more deeply, we can see the sunshine in it. Without sunshine, the forest cannot grow. In fact, nothing can grow without sunshine. And so we know that the sunshine is also in this sheet of paper. The paper and the sunshine inter are. And if we continue to look, we can see the logger who cut the tree and brought it to the mill to be transformed into paper. And we see wheat. We know that the logger cannot exist without his or her daily bread, and therefore the wheat cannot exist without the wheat that became the bread is also in the sheet of paper. The logger's father and mother are in it too. When we look in this way, we see that without all of these things, this sheet of paper cannot exist. Looking even more deeply, we can see ourselves in this sheet of paper too. This is not difficult to see because when we look at a sheet of paper, it is part of our perception. Your mind is in here and mine is also. So we can say that everything is in here with this sheet of paper. We cannot point out one thing that is not here. Time, space, the earth, the rain, the minerals and the soil, the sunshine, the cloud, the river, the heat, everything coexists with this sheet of paper. That is why I think the word interbe should be in the dictionary. To be is to interbe. We cannot just be by ourselves alone. We have to interbe with every other thing. This sheet of paper is because everything else is. So there's a little philosophical talk for you. But I love that reminder. To get out of that compartmentalization of thinking of our separateness, but instead feeling into our union, which is ultimately what yoga is constantly a practice of. So as you find a comfortable seat, begin to connect with your physical being. Taking a moment to feel into whatever sensations are present and letting you know about your physical state. Tune into your energetic being as you might sense in the quality of your breathing, just as it is. Perhaps also relating you to your mental state as you begin to pay more attention to your thoughts. Quality and energy of your thoughts. Which then is interconnected with your emotional state. What's alive in you right now? And gathering in acknowledgement of all these various layers of self. Perhaps joining the palms to meet at your heart. Clarify why you showed up today in your yoga practice. setting your intention. And together, as we share the practice, remembering our interbeing, let's join our voices in the chant of Om three times, emptying this breath first. Take a deep inhale. Bowing in, perhaps acknowledge another being whom you could dedicate your practice to today. And with that, let's begin to deepen the breath in, slowly filling it up to the top. And then letting any sound release through the mouth as you completely empty the breath. And perhaps a little slower inhalation. Maybe lingering at the top for a few seconds, keeping the body relaxed. And just as long, an exhalation through the mouth again. Maybe lingering at the bottom for a few seconds. And then one more time, just like that. See if you can continue to gently whisper your breath both in and out while closing your lips and just breathing through your nose. By gently, softly narrowing the back of your throat to practice Ujjayi Pranayama, which means victorious breathing. So listening to that full length of inhale match that full length of exhale, smoothly transitioning between. Softly open your eyes if they're closed. And as you extend your left arm, I'm mirroring you here, out to the left side, flex your hand at the wrist, and then bring your right hand to the left side of your skull, gently leaning your right ear towards your right shoulder, opening up into the left side of your neck. And as you press your left and right sitting bones into the surface below, lift from the lower spine, up each vertebra. Deep inhalation. Slow exhalation. Feel the energy of your left hand, the fingertips reaching towards the sky as the heel of your left palm reaches towards your left wall. Feel into the tops of your shoulders, allow them to soften downward, both away from your neck. And then listen in on three more deep breaths in this position. Letting that soft whispering sound of your breath guide your attention into each present moment. And as you completely empty this next breath, softly release your left arm, lift the crown of your head, and let's first rotate the shoulders. Inhale them forward and up. Exhale them back and down. Two more. Inhale forward and up. Exhale back and down. Once more. And then as you relax the shoulders, extend your right arm out to the right. Flex at the wrist so the fingertips are pointing up. Place the left hand on the right side of your skull and gently lean your left ear towards your left shoulder. Feel your pelvis rooting into the surface below. as you lift from the bottom of your spine up each vertebra, broadening your chest. And now feel into the muscles in your face. Notice the area right between your eyebrows, the skin on your forehead. Feel into the area behind your ears, down your jawline, into your mouth. And again, let's listen for three more full cycles of breath. As you finish this exhalation, relax. And if you are sitting cross-legged, I invite you to switch the cross of your legs. One more time, ground to the left and right sitting bones, lift through the center of your spine. And as you press your hands down into your lap, begin to lean the torso forward, taking a deep breath in, circle the torso to the left side, leaning back. Exhale to the right side, then leaning forward. And just like that, take a few more circles of your spine. Feel the stability of the four points at the bottom of your pelvis. And then go in the opposite direction when you're ready, inhaling. Exhaling. Gently warming up into your sacrum, your lower back, your hips. One more cycle of breath. And let's make our way onto all fours, hands and knees. Setting your knees a couple inches behind your hips, set your wrists right under the shoulders. On your next in-breath, reach your right arm up towards the sky, opening wide across your chest. Then exhale to slide the right arm underneath your left bent elbow so the right palm is face up. As you lean the right side of your head on the ground or on top of a prop, level the height of your left and right hips and feel your rib cage gently turning along the axis of your spine. Full breath in, allow the backs of your lungs to gently press into the back wall of your rib cage. Feel the space in your neck. About three more breaths here and thread the needle. Finishing this exhalation, slowly rise back to hands and knees. On a deep inhale, reach your left arm up high, opening your chest wide. Exhale, thread your left arm underneath your right bent elbow. With your left palm facing up, lean the left side of your head onto the ground or onto a prop. Feel your left and right hips re-level in height. And then allow the twist to deepen across your waistline. Filling up your in-breath, especially right between your shoulder blades. For about three more cycles. So we had a request to focus a bit on physically opening the neck, the shoulders, the lower back. But in that idea of interbeing, notice how that affects other areas like your toes or your tongue or so bring into that perspective of your practice today these interrelationships. Slowly come on up to hands and knees. Please spin out your hands from the wrists so that maybe your fingertips point towards the left and right edges of your mat some degree, maybe towards your knees if that's comfortable. Offering your inner wrist a stretch as we begin cat-cow, inhaling, glide your chest through your upper arms, coiling it up, drop your shoulders. Exhaling, contract your belly, maybe even tuck your toes for a bit more sensation, stretching the lower back. Inhale, again, lift the heart forward and towards the sky. Exhale, lifting your navel, dome your back. And take about three more slow cycles of breath, extending and flexing your spine. You remember that this is your practice. Notice what your body is asking for in each posture, each movement. Bringing that mindful attention to your breath as it guides you as well. Taking moments to rest or vary a pose as often as you need. As you relax to a neutral spine, come to sit on your shins for a moment. Let's make fists with the hands. We're going to give the opposite sides of the wrists a stretch. Give yourself a fist bump and then place the backs of your fists about a foot forward of your knees. Flaring your elbows apart, begin to lean forward just to the amount of stretch you want to feel in your outer wrists and forearms. And here, maybe begin to shake your head no. Perhaps also fluttering your lips or making funny faces, stretching your mouth. Noticing if there's anything to unpack in the muscles in your face. Maybe there's sound that wants to go through. Maybe tilting your chin up as though nodding your head yes, your chin to your chest. A couple more breaths here. Full inhalations. Deep cleansing exhalations. Start to make our way into downward facing dog as you spread your fingers wide and point your index fingers straight ahead or slightly turn them out. And with your feet hips distance apart and parallel, lift your hips as high as possible towards your rear wall. You might take the first few breaths here to pedal your feet in place and warm up the backs of your legs. Maybe also swiveling your hips left and right, or moving your skull a bit more to loosen your neck as you lift the shoulders away from it. Find the version of downward facing dog that allows you to feel as though you have a flat back. Your neck feels spacious as you drop the head easily. And weight is traveling down the backs of your legs through your heels, even if your heels are not touching the ground. You might be bending your knees here. Then stilling your body in that position, steady your gaze on one spot, and listen to your breath. Adho Mukha Svanasana. On your next inhale, bend your knees and lift your heels and hips high. Look forward past your hands. As you exhale, walk up to the front of your mat into a standing forward fold. Separating your feet, still hips distance and parallel. Bend your knees any amount to allow your spine to lengthen. Press your fingertips on the ground ahead or your legs. And as you firm in your belly, inhale, lift your chest towards the front wall. Exhale, fold in. Firming down to your feet, inhale, circle your arms towards the sky. As your palms meet, look up. This gesture of gratitude, hands in prayer, bring them together at your heart. Let's flow one breath each movement, starting in Sun Salutation B, a variation. Inhale, circle your arms overhead and look up. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, press your legs to the ground, look forward, lengthen. With hands on blocks or the ground, exhale, step the left knee behind you into a kneeling lunge, look up. Inhale, plant your hands and step into your plank pose. Legs straight or knees on the ground. Exhale, glide forward, grazing your elbows by your ribs through chaturanga, come all the way down. With heels of your palms alongside your floating ribs, inhale into a light cobra pose, lifting your chest. Tucking your toes, press the floor away, exhale to downward facing dog. Deep inhale, step your left foot beside your left thumb, lowering your right knee, look up. Exhale, step your right foot to the top of your mat and fold. Pressing to your feet, inhale, circle your arms, rise up, palms meeting in prayer. And as though blessing yourself here, exhale, trace your palms in prayer down your midline. Side two, one more. Inhale, sweep your arms overhead. Exhale, bow forward. Press the ground of your legs. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step your right knee back and look up. Inhale, step into plank pose. Exhale, glide forward and through Chaturanga Dandasana to the floor. Press the tops of your feet down. Inhale, coil your chest into cobra. Exhale, lift through the belly, downward facing dog. Inhale, step the right foot beside your right thumb. Lower your back knee and look up. Exhale, step the left foot forward and bow. Root to your feet, inhale, rise to the top. Palms meet. Exhale, blessing yourself down your center. Moving into Surya Namaskar A. Inhale, sweep your arms overhead. Exhale, bow in towards the earth. Inhale, expand your heart forward, look forward. Step into plank and exhale, glide forward through Chaturanga. This time choose cobra or upward facing dog as you inhale. Exhale into downward facing dog. Pausing there for three slow breaths, balancing in with out. Feel the openness across your shoulders as you relax your neck. Feel the groundedness of the base of your thumb and index fingers. On your third exhalation, finish the out breath, then walk or float to the top of your mat. Inhale, lift your heart and lengthen forward. Exhale, fold. Root to your feet, inhale, rise and expand, look up. Exhale, down your center. Twice more, sun salutation A. Inhale, sweep the space around you. Exhale, dive in. Inhale, offer your heart forward, long spine. Step or float into Chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your own, take three or more breaths here, resteadying your breath pace. When you feel ready, at the end of an exhale, walk or float to the top. Take one more sun salutation. We'll meet in downward facing dog. Pace with your breath. Taking your own pace to eventually arrive at downward facing dog. Let's slow down the breath again and tune in to those various layers of self. How are you currently affecting your body, your mind, your breath, your emotional, energetic state?
as you root down to your fingers spread, inhale, raise your right leg behind you. Exhaling, bend your right knee and turn the thigh open at the hip. Take another breath in and tack your left outer hip back. Exhaling, softly tap your right knee outside of your right elbow or upper arm and gently step the foot outside of your right hand. Coming into a lizard lunge with your back knee lifted or resting on the ground. Feel free to have blocks under your hands for this little flow. As you inhale in your lizard lunge, sinking your hips, draw your sternum towards the front of your mat. Exhale, begin to scissor your right hip back into a wide version of pyramid pose, straightening the front leg as you fold inside of it. Let's take that for four more rounds of breath. Inhale, lizard lunge again. Exhale, pyramid pose. Inhale, lizard lunge. Exhale, pyramid pose. Inhale, lizard. Exhale, pyramid. And inhale, lizard. Exhale, pyramid. Coming back to a lunge, step your right foot front and center between your hands and spin the back heel down for warrior two. Aligning front heel to arch a back foot, cartwheel your arms apart to rise. As you're turning out your right thigh from the hip, bend your front knee right on top of the heel, tracking the center of the knee, your middle toe facing forward. Press the outside edge of your left foot into the ground, completely straightening your left leg as you firm the top of the left thigh bone back. Feel your two shoulders stack right above your two hips, with arms wide open, energy through the fingertips. Gazing past your right hand, let's take three last breaths here in Virabhadrasana 2. Straighten your front leg for triangle. You might opt to slightly shorten your stance, maybe 2 to 3 inches less. Glide your hips towards the back of your mat and reach your right hand towards your front wall as far as you can before placing that hand onto your right leg or just to the right of your leg, maybe using a block. And as you raise your left arm up, turn your chest slightly to face the sky. If it feels okay on your neck, steady your gaze up past your left thumb. Feel your right glute wrap under your body as you tack the crease of your right hip back towards your left outer foot, while reaching the crown of your head forward towards your front wall. Let's take about four more breaths in Trikonasana, or triangle pose. Moving into half moon pose, you might place your left hand on your left hip. Steady your gaze on the ground just ahead of your right foot and bend your right knee. Crawl your right fingertips onto the ground or a block about 6 inches ahead of your right pinky toe out to the right upper corner. Dragging in your left foot, flex it as you lift the leg about parallel to the ground. Notice that your right hip is still wrapping under. Your right foot hasn't changed its orientation from triangle. And then you're turning your chest to face your left wall, just like you did in triangle. Basically, triangle pose with one leg in the air. And then you might explore raising the left arm or coming into chapasana, which means bending your left knee towards your belly and using your left hand to catch the top of your left foot. As you kick the left leg towards your back wall, you're pulling the foot towards your glute, opening the front of your left shoulder and your quadricep. Whatever you choose, how is your breath affecting your balance right now? How is what you're paying attention to affecting your experience in the context of this yoga pose? take about three more breaths in your version of Ardha Chandrasana. If your left knee is bent in Shavasana, slowly straighten the leg back. Then take your time stepping back to Warrior Two. Taking an inhale in Warrior Two. And exhaling, stepping back to Downward Facing Dog or flowing through a Vinyasa if you choose. Feel into the length of your in-breath again and your out-breath again. As you press into the earth, inhale, raise your left leg behind you. Exhale, bend your left knee and rotate the thigh open at the hip. Inhaling here, tack your right outer hip back. Then exhale, tap your left knee to the outside of your left upper arm or elbow, gently stepping the left foot to the outside of your left hand in lizard lunge. Back knee on the floor lifted. Try to take the same version as you did on the first side, maybe using blocks under your hands. Inhaling in your lizard lunge, reach your heart forward. Exhaling, begin to scissor your left hip back into a wide version of pyramid pose, bowing to the inside of your front leg. Let's keep flowing. Inhale, lizard lunge. Exhale, pyramid pose. Last three breaths. Inhale, lizard. Exhale, pyramid. Inhale, lizard. Exhale, pyramid. And inhale, lizard. Exhale, pyramid. Turning to your lunge, step your left foot right between your hands, front and center on your mat, and spin your right heel down, aligning front heel to arch your back foot. Cartwheel your arms to rise up into Warrior Two. As you're turning the left thigh open, wrap the sitting bone underneath and align your front knee with your middle toe. Straightening your right leg, firm the outside edge of that foot into the earth. Feel your two shoulders stack right above your two hips. As you reach your arms wide open, steady your gaze just past your left hand. And let's feel into the balance in the breath. Then straightening your left leg, prepare for triangle, maybe by shortening your stance a couple inches. Glide your hips towards the back edge of your mat and reach your left hand far forward before placing that hand onto your left leg or just to the left of it, maybe on a block. As you raise your right arm up, turn your chest slightly to face the sky and send both of your shoulder heads down your back away from your neck. Wrapping the left hip under and tack the crease of that hip back as you reach the top of your head towards your front wall. Steady your gaze onto one spot and let's take another three breaths here in Trikonasana. Remember how the shape of this pose feels, because we're basically going to recreate it in half moon. In transitioning, you might bring your right hand to your right hip. Take a look at the ground ahead of your left foot and bend your left knee. Place your left fingertips on a block of the floor 6 inches ahead of your left pinky toe, then out to the left. Drag your right foot forward and flex the foot as you raise the leg parallel to the floor. Turn your chest to face the right wall, just like you did in triangle. Maybe explore raising the right arm up
If you did so on the first side, maybe explore Chapasana, bending your right knee towards your belly, catching the top of the foot with your right hand, and kicking your right leg towards your back wall as you pull the foot towards your glute. Make sure here that your knee is not pointing up towards the sky, rather it's pointing towards the back wall. So this is more of a sideways gesture. Then again, back to the breath, steadying your eyes. Very slowly, if your right knee is bent, straighten the leg back to half moon or Ardha Chandrasana. Then gently step back to Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2. Inhaling there. Exhale, place your hands at the top of your mat and please step forward, letting your feet come together to touch in a forward fold. With your big toes together, bend your knees together and sit back towards your heels, maybe grazing the floor with your fingertips as you play with keeping your hips that low, raise your arms up for a few breaths in Utkatasana chair pose. Gliding your shin bones back, peek down, make sure that you can see your toes from where you are. Then look forward and let your shoulders soften down. Hug in the belly, drop the tailbone. Last two breaths here as we start to flow in Sun Salutation B twice. One breath, each movement. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift your chest, rising halfway. Exhale, walk to plank and lower or float to Chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg from the inseam. Exhale, step the foot beside your right thumb with feet hips width apart, spin the back heel down. Face forward and rise on an inhale to Warrior One. Exhale, lower into Chaturanga to flow, or maybe take a few cat-cows instead. In downward facing dog, inhale, lift your left leg back from the inseam. Exhale, step the foot beside your left thumb with feet hips width apart, drop the back heel. Face forward and rise as you breathe in, Warrior One. Exhale into your vinyasa, all the way through. In downward facing dog, take about 3 slow breaths. Remember, as you regulate your breath to sustain mindfully, you regulate your body's movements to sustain mindfully. Feel how one affects the other. Bend your knees, look forward, empty the breath. Then walk or float to the top with feet touching. Inhale, lift your chest forward. Exhale, fold. With knees touching, inhale, sit back into chair. Completing this round, exhale, rise to mountain pose. Let's take one more and we'll meet standing here at the top of your mat. Starting together, inhale, chair. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, walk back or float back to Chaturanga. Flow through your vinyasa at the pace of your breath. And without rushing, when you arrive at downward dog, inhale to raise your right leg. Exhale, step it forward. And inhale, rise to Warrior One. Exhale to lower into your vinyasa. Again, when you arrive at downward dog, inhale, raise your left leg. Exhale, step it forward. Inhale, rise to Warrior One. Exhale, into your vinyasa.
downward dog for 3 to 5 breaths, taking rest whenever you need it. As you feel ready to close this last sun salutation B, after emptying your breath, walk or float to the top. Inhaling to lift your heart forward. Exhale to fold. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale to rise up. And as we meet at the top of your mat, maybe close your eyes and take a few deep breaths, grounding, recentering, and tuning back in. What's alive in your body right now? And then please find your strap. As you step at the top of your mat, separate your feet hips width apart, then place your blocks on their tallest height to the outside of your heels. With your two hips facing forward, step your left foot back 2/3 as far as you would in Warrior One. Slightly shorter stance where your feet are hips width apart, hips equally facing forward, legs straight, and both feet entirely on the ground. Then hold the strap in your left hand and raise your left hand, dangling the long end of the strap behind your back. With the help of your right hand, rotate your left outer upper arm slightly to face forward. Press your two shoulders down your back as you bring the left elbow behind your head. Reach your right hand underneath behind you and catch hold of the other end of the strap. Walk your hands as close together as you can. If your hands meet to clasp, you can drop the strap. Spread your toes without gripping the mat and activate the muscles in your legs, especially your quadriceps, as well as your belly. Inhale, lift your heart and look up towards the sky. Keep the belly firm and exhale, begin to hinge forward from your hips towards the inside of your right leg, then pause. Level the height of your two hips. Length through the spine, reaching through your sternum. Exhale, fold another little bit. And just like that, breath by breath, ease into exploring the range of your pyramid pose, or Parsvottanasana. Keeping your chest and throat open. One more breath here. Firming the belly in, rooting down through the legs. Inhale, lift your spine about parallel to the floor. Prepare for a twist by lowering the left hand to start on the left side of your front foot on a block of the floor. Take the right thumb, hook the crease of your right outer hip, and gently press it back to re-level your two hips. Another option to deepen the twist is to place the left hand on the right side of your front foot on a block of the floor. Might even help to keep your hips leveled by placing a block at the lowest tip of your lower back, right across your hips, trying to keep the block leveled. Inhale, reach the top of your head forward, down the midline of your mat. Exhale, at your waistline, begin to turn your chest to the right, breath by breath, raising the right arm up to revolve triangle pose. One more deep breath here. If you have a block balancing on your lower back, go ahead and place it on the ground. Lower your two hands, crawl them about a foot ahead of your right foot, easing on the ground past your hands. Put a little bend in your right knee and shift right into Warrior Three by lifting from the inseam of your left leg, and flexing your left foot. Again, level the height of your two hips. And draw your sternum towards your front wall. You could stay in this variation of Warrior Three, or add a twist, which will bring you into revolved half moon. Get there, place the left hand on the ground or a block, 1 foot in front of your right big toe. You might use your right thumb again to hook the crease of the right hip back, helping to re-level your hips. On an inhale, press the left heel back and reach the top of your head forward. On an exhale, keep the hips leveled and twist from your waistline to the right, raising your right arm up. Now, there are other variations of this posture, sort of like we played with in half moon. You could bend the left knee, possibly catch hold of the top of the left foot with your right hand, and with a little bend in the right knee, kicking the left foot away as you pull the foot towards you, maybe lifting the torso into a revolved standing bow pose. Notice your breath, whatever variation you can. The posture be the context in which you're practicing yoga, that union of body, breath, mind, spirit. Your time. You're in the twist, come back to both hands on the floor, Warrior Three. From there, inhale, lift the chest, look forward. And exhale, cross the left foot in front of the right foot, stepping your left foot to the right side of your mat, crisscross, standing forward fold. Bend your left knee slightly. Inhale, lift your heart forward. Exhale, hinge from your hips. Let's take a few breaths here. Now you might opt to place your hands in the backs of your legs. Place your hands on blocks. See what works for your body. Release the neck. All these forward folds are opportunities to let go of what we might clench into the neck, the shoulders, or even the mind. Literally shifting our perspective each time. Take a deep inhale through the nose, then open the mouth, let any sound out, lion's breath. Place your hands on blocks on the floor and uncross your legs. Sweep your arms to the sky, inhale to rise. Raise your hands down your midline as you exhale to mountain pose. Gather your blocks again and let them frame your feet at the top of your mat. Take your strap, then step your right foot back 2/3 as far as you did in Warrior One. Making sure your two hips are facing forward, 2 feet are grounded, your two legs are straight. Then holding the strap in your right hand, dangle the tail behind your back. Raise your right arm. Use your left hand to help you rotate your right tricep slightly towards the front wall. Bend the elbow behind your head and draw the two shoulders down. Then reach your left hand underneath behind you to catch hold of the other end of the strap. Walking your hands as close together as you can, see if you might clasp your hands and drop the strap or not. Then energize your legs and belly. Inhale, look up, lift your heart. Exhale, hinge just a little bit of your range. Taking your time with each breath as you keep your hips leveled or squared and continue to lengthen your sternum towards the front wall. Pyramid pose or Parsvottanasana. Notice the space throughout your neck, especially at your throat. Keep that open for your breath. Belly and legs firm. Inhale, lift the spine parallel to the ground. Lower your right hand to start at the right side of your left foot on the floor or block. You might like to hook the left thumb onto the crease of your left outer hip. Help to rebalance your hips. Maybe even place a block on the lowest part of your lower back. If you want a deeper twist, you can cross the right hand to the left side of your left foot. Inhale, stretch the top of your head down the center of your mat. Exhale, let your waistline twist to your left, raising the left arm. Keep going with each breath, exploring the range of your spinal twist in revolved triangle pose, or Paritta Trikonasana. One more breath here. Then, if you have a block on your lower back, set it on the ground. Place your hands on blocks or the ground, 1 foot ahead of your left foot. And begin to shift into Warrior Three. Lifting from the inseam of your right leg, flex your right foot. Engage your belly and draw your heart through the gates of your arms. Stay here or prepare for revolved half moon by placing your right hand on a block of the floor, 1 foot in front of your left big toe. Perhaps use your left thumb again to hook the crease of your left outer hip back and re-level your hips while you inhale to lengthen through the center line of your body. And exhale, turn your chest to the left, little by little, raising your left arm up in Paritta Ardha Chandrasana. You did so on the first side, you might bend your right knee and catch the top of the foot with your left hand, kicking the leg back as you pull the foot, maybe bend the left knee, and begin to lift the right arm towards the front of the room. Revolved standing bow pose. Wherever you are here, let's take another 3 or so deep breaths. Slowly, if you are in some version of revolved half moon, place your 2 hands down, back to Warrior Three. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, cross your right foot in front of your left foot and over to the left side of your mat. Crisscross, standing forward fold. Bend your right knee and inhale, lift your heart. Then exhale, fold in for a few breaths. Placing your hands wherever it helps you to stabilize in this posture and find your range. Let your head hang loose. No added tension in the neck, shoulders, or jaw. Maybe flutter the lips a few times. Notice what patterns arise when you're focusing a lot, maybe in a balancing posture. Might be parallel to focusing when you're at work in front of the computer. Patterns arise in your mind, body, or breath. Your yoga practice, bring awareness to create new patterns that serve you. As you place your hands on the ground or blocks, inhale, lift your chest and uncross your legs. Find your version of a squat. You might take a couple of blocks and place them on the ground to sit on. Separate your feet wider than hips width apart and turn out your thighs from the hips so that your knees are turned out the same amount as your middle toes. Some of you might hover your pelvis off the floor. Then take a moment to use your arms to gently splay your inner thighs apart, root down to your tailbone and feet, and then lift up to your heart and your crown. The shoulders roll back and down. Maybe bring the hands in prayer at your heart. Take a slow inhale as if breathing up your spine from tailbone to crown. Then take just as slow to empty the breath from crown down to tailbone. 2 more breaths.
in a variation of malasana, squat. And then take your time to come all the way down to sit. Bend your knees apart and bring the soles of your feet together to touch. Catching hold of your big toes or your outer feet. Bring your heels close to your pelvis and root your pelvis down as you breathe up again to your, through your spine. Then exhale, extend your heart forward and bow. Maybe walking the hands forward. Baddha Konasana, bound angle pose. Then leading with your chest, inhale, slowly rise up. Extend your left leg forward and step your right foot in front of your right hip. Holding that shin with your left hand, backstroke your right hand to the floor behind your pelvis. Inhale, sit up a little taller, stack your crown above your tailbone. Exhale, draw in your belly and twist to your right. You might bring the left elbow to cross to the outside of the right thigh or not. Three more breaths here. Relax your shoulders downward. Lift your spine upward. As you exhale, unwind your spine and straighten your right leg forward. Step your left foot on the floor in front of your left hip. Hold on to that shin with your right hand. Backstroke your left hand to the ground behind your pelvis. Sit a bit taller as you inhale. Hollow your belly and twist as you exhale to your left. With the option of hooking the right elbow outside of your left thigh. About three more breaths. Feel your collarbones splay open wide. On your next breath out, release from the twist. Let's take a block, place it right between your thighs, skinny width, and let's set up for one bridge pose. Set your feet on the ground, and bring your arms down by your sides. Have your heels just close enough where you could almost touch them with your fingertips, but not quite. Parallel your feet apart, then inhale, lift your pelvis off the floor, actively stretching the front of your thighs towards your front wall. Keep breathing deeply and walk your upper arms closer together beneath your back ribs with elbows straight, not bent. If your hands meet, interlace your fingers. As you tilt your chin slightly back, open your throat. Feel the fullness of each breath as you take five more, less more, before slowly lowering one vertebra at a time. Bridge pose, or Setu Bandha Sarvangasana. When you've decided to lower your pelvis, put the block aside and hug your bent knees into your chest. Maybe rocking side to side, maybe taking happy baby pose, just another half a minute for whatever gentle movement or posture helps you to wind down into your final resting pose.
place your body in a position where it can be completely still and at ease while you close your eyes and release control of your breathing, offering yourself full presence in Shavasana. As you keep your eyes closed, gently take a deep breath in. And opening your lips, begin to move slowly, small parts of your body first, like your fingers and toes. Easing into larger parts. Taking your time, you might draw your knees into your chest and give yourself a full-on hug. Perhaps turn over to your right side. Gradually rise into a comfortable seat for our 5 minutes of meditation. Now offer your body a position of rest, ease, and alertness. Bring a gesture to your hands that serves your meditation practice. For the feeling of interconnectedness, you might let the palms rest one on top of the other, face up, thumb tips touching, or bring fingertips of each hand, opposite hand together, like you're holding a sphere between the palms and just letting the hands rest in front of you. Mudra of the five elements. Then either close your eyes or steady a soft gaze ahead as you sit tall, shoulders relaxed, heart space open. Feel your breath and how your body naturally receives the breath in and the space around you and the trees outside, from all that contribute to that life force traveling into your physical being. And as you naturally breathe out, feel the way your body releases what the trees need, carbon dioxide, for their own life force. Notice the interplay with life around you, through the natural flow of your in-breath and out-breath. And notice how your body knows just what to do to be in harmony with the life around you. You don't even have to tell your body to breathe. And so for the silence remaining in this meditation practice, I invite you to meditate on just that. Feeling interbeing with life around you, including these individuals who are practicing with you today. bring your palms to meet at your heart center, bowing in towards your heart as you lift it. Close this practice today with one chant of Om, feeling the resonance that you share with all who are practicing with you live, even those who might be watching this recording later. You're sharing your energy in the space, receiving it too. Take a deep breath. The light in me bows to the light in you. Namaste.